And welcome back, Tank Commanders. This is Mr. Kasari. Today we are going to be looking at the LAV 300. This is a Tier 4 tank destroyer. Alright, so in my last video you saw me discuss tank destroyers a little bit. Alright, the LAV 300 is a pretty nice one. It is Tier 4. And it packs a pretty decent punch. Let's take a quick look at this. Alright, so it is a Wolfly vehicle. As you can see with the tank storage, you start with the Dragoon 90 and then you move on to the LAV 300 series. Okay? It is a development of the LAV 150-90. Alright? Which is a 4x4 vehicle, and you can see it here as a premium tier 3. It was developed by Cadillac Gauge or Textron Marine and Land Division, which is now what Cadillac Gauge is known as, during the 1970s as a private export venture based on the LAV 150-90. First prototype was completed in 1979 with Panama as the first customer. Not many people ordered this thing. The Kuwaiti National Guard ordered 62 of them, and the Philippines has a couple as well. The LAV 300 is fully amphibious without advanced preparation with a top speed in water of 3 kilometers per hour. Optionally, customers can also get it equipped with pump jets that increase that speed to 8 kilometers per hour. So you're not going to set any speed records, and you're pretty much only going to be operating in shallow water and calm water. However, it is amphibious, so when we get that in the game, this will have that capability. Alright, it has been deployed by Panama, the Philippines, Venezuela, and it was deployed by Kuwait. Sources differ, so some of the sites I've seen said that it was deployed by the United States, some said it was not deployed by the United States. I suspect there's some information that it was tested by the U.S. For the United States Marine Corps, but that it was rejected, and that the Army tested it and also rejected it in favor of the M113, I believe. I don't remember the designation. The Striker. M1128. Which is a variant of the Striker ICV. The M1128 is the Striker mobile gun system. Okay, so what do I think about this tank? Oh, combat history. Almost forgot. There isn't much, and what there is out there, yeah. So we know that they were involved in the Iraqi invasion of Kuwait in 1990. The Kuwaitis had 62 of them. They were all destroyed, but I can't find any information on how well they did before they got themselves blown up. We also know that the Philippine Marine Corps has deployed it against the Moro Islamic Liberation Front, although again, details are sketchy, and if you check the Wikipedia article, there's a giant citation needed sign next to that statement. So, in other words, we don't have a lot of information on this vehicle, alright? It hasn't been deployed a lot in real life. It hasn't seen a lot of combat in real life. That's partially because tank destroyers in general haven't seen a lot of combat in real life. Most of the countries that deploy them are countries that can't afford to deploy tanks or are deploying them with paratroopers. This vehicle is air mobile. However, the U.S. military decided on the mobile gun system, Striker, instead. So, yeah. Not a lot of information IRL to go on. Most nations that deploy these sort of tanks or tank destroyers can't afford main battle tanks or modern main MBTs, and they see these sort of tank destroyers as a way to get a fairly powerful weapons platform with almost main battle tank firepower in a very compact small package. So let's take a look at our upgrades over here. All right, upgrade tree. I have this one fully completed and battle hardened, which tells you that No, I don't have a battle hardened. I like this vehicle. I actually like it quite a bit. You get a bit more speed, an extra technology retrofit slot, and a universal slot. You get some pretty good weapons platforms all the way up through here. And you would get both the magnetic actuator, the upgraded transmission, and Ioannis Sana as your commander, who I haven't purchased yet, but whatever. All right, so let's actually look at the detail stats on this thing, shall we? Alright, so we're going to compare this to... I'm not certain we're going to compare this to, actually. Because there's really only one chain of tank destroyers right now. We could compare it to the MX-10P Pack 90, but that's a premium, and I don't think that's really a fair comparison. So why don't we compare it to another Tier 4 vehicle? Let's compare it to the Starship. As an MBT. And we'll compare it to the Sheridan Light Tank and the BMD-1 Armored Fighting Vehicle. We are not going to compare it. And we could also compare it to the Zalo S, but again, that's premium, so it shouldn't be as good as this thing will be. Alright, let's pull this over here. LAV-300. Now, this LAV-300 is fully upgraded with its, I believe, top-tier heat rounds. Yes. And we're comparing it to these two tanks. Now, we're not going to compare the damage that this thing does, or any of the real details, because again, this is upgraded fast fire. You know, I have all the modules on it, I have all the upgrades, I have a commander in it. But let's just compare it to the damage on the stock rounds, okay? So the BMD-1... My screen just did something entertaining back behind me. Okay. We're going to have to close this out. We're going to go back to garage. There we go. So let's look at this versus the Sheridan, all right? So the Sheridan has front armor of 65 millimeters. All right, this upgraded heat round is going to go straight through it. All right, penetration of 187. All right, this Sheridan is going to get penned no matter what side you're shooting at. It might glance around off of its turret with that sloping, but if you get flat armor, this is going to just go straight through it. Absolutely straight through it. In terms of its gun, sustained damage on this is 5,517. Well, yes, okay. Yeah. This is a tank destroyer. It fires fast. It has a 90mm gun, so it's going to fire faster than this 152. Its damage is 388 versus 407. Now, I don't think I have any damage upgrades here. Nope, I just have the thermal sleeve and the intercom system. All right. View range is pretty good for this LAV at 457, again, with upgrades and crew. And running Sabrina Washington. So it's probably about 400, so it's still a little better. Mobility is better. Yeah. So what is better about the LAV-300? Well, first of all, the Sheridan is not upgraded, but you can see the Sheridan actually has better alpha than the LAV-300 does. Okay? Second, if we look at the Sheridan's upgrade tree, we can see that its maximum heat round is going to have a penetration of 316 and 472, which is going to be a heck of a lot better than this LAV-300. All right. So the Sheridan is absolutely going to beat the LAV-300 for firepower. What it is not going to beat, however, is the LAV-300's mobility. Well, it might eventually when it's upgraded, but it's not going to beat the turret traverse, the aim time, the accuracy, or for that matter, the reload speed. I can fire around every 4.22 seconds. All right. That's pretty fast at tier 4. 4.22 out of a standard 90mm gun. That's pretty darn fast. All right. Now, one of the advantages of the Sheridan, is that it has better armor. All right. Look at the armor on this LAV-300. 10, 10, and 8. That's not going to work. That just simply is not going to go. All right. Yeah, 10, 10, 8. And the turret's 10, 10, 10 all around. And that's Catalloy, so it has a bit better modifier, but that's still not going to make up for the fact that the Sheridan just has more armor. All right. The LAV-300 is not going to deflect shells. All right. Even autocannon, probably not going to deflect autocannon rounds. Just don't get hit. All right. Conversely, the LAV is a bit better at hiding. All right. So let's compare it to the Starship now. I think these are the only two comparisons we're actually going to do. My Starship is upgraded, okay? You can see the Starship has better alpha and pen, but again, the LAV-300 beats it in this configuration, and in any configuration, for damage per minute, simply because of its high reload time. We're going to skip armor except for the fact that on a straight shot, your heat shell can penetrate the starship if you don't hit the sloped armor. You're probably going to have a bit of a hard time in certain areas of the starship, but most of the time you're going to just punch straight through his hull armor. Turret armor. Don't hit the front turret armor. You will not pen it unless you hit a weak point. There are several weak points. But this is not a video on the starship. This is a video on the LAV. We're not going to talk about the SIG's armor. You are much more mobile than the starship. Much, much more mobile. The downside you have is that you're a wheeled vehicle, so one, you are a pain in the neck to steer, and two, you have much worse performance on soft terrain. Remember that. Utility, camouflage, well, you can outspot him in this configuration, and you have better camouflage than he does. That's fine. Gun depression. He actually has better forward gun depression than you, but you have much better rear gun depression. All right, just keep that in mind. You are marginally more accurate. Your aim time is about 39.39 seconds better, and your turret traverse is a little bit better than the starship. Okay, so why don't we see what this guy can do in combat now? Now understand, I am a PvE player almost entirely. I play straight up PvE, and this is going to be a medium match, all right? So let's take a look at this map. This is Operation Prometheus in my LAV 300, and let's hit play. Now, I would believe I was running this match with my friend Battlemind Jace. There he is in the swing fire. So, he's in a swing fire. Yeah. Good luck to him. In this mission, you're going to see, in some ways, how you should and should not play a tank destroyer. I got aggressive, okay? I got too aggressive and almost paid for it quite dearly. But what I was able to do was I was able, essentially, to play support for, I believe, this OF-40 next to me. I think it was the OF-40. We'll find out as soon as the map starts. All right, there we go. We have 15 minutes, and we're off.
Today is to retrieve the nuclear missiles and their launch codes. They are being transported in the wrecked cargo ship along the shore.
This mission lasted for 10 minutes. So, here we go. So you can see Jace is going up ahead scouting for me, which I appreciate immensely. I just go through the tree because I don't care. So,
good luck. And back up.
This being PvE, I do some things that would get me murdered in PvE. So I'm going to stop here. I'm ignoring that Pac-10. I'm looking at the... Nope, I'm not now. So I just took out the Pac-10. The AMX-10 P90, excuse me. And another AMX-10 P90. I've already reloaded. I missed the shot. And I take him out. Right before Jace gets him. Or did I take him out there? I don't know. You saw Jace fired a missile there, but I got the kill first. All right, so now I see this superior M41. I'm taking a shot. I'm already reloaded. I'm shooting again. I'm not really hiding. I just take a hit. I'm trying to figure out where it came from. I figure it's Artie. Yep, it's Artie. So I'm backing out of there. I get stopped by my buddy in the swing fire. Thanks, Tim. Jace. And I missed a shot of that BMD. But I see this guy coming up. I fire. Jace fires. He fires a second missile and gets the kill. Now I see this Bagel Panzer. Bagel Panzer is bad. Bagel Panzer is very bad. I miss my first shot. I back up a bit more. I get the second shot on him. And I get the kill too. Now, I'm not really hiding as much as I should be here. I'm pretty in the open, all things considered. Well, no, I mean, there's enough bushes here that I'm pretty hidden. And I'm waiting for the shot, and I take the shot. Now, if you notice, I'm actually playing very up front. This is our M60 that I'm right next to here. All right, so I was asking... You'll notice sometimes that I delay my shots because I'm asking Jace if he has a line. because
the
he's in a swing fire, and he desperately needs kills.
Find them and destroy them before they can escape and use it again.
So they're pinging down there to say, hey, someone, take out that helo and that arty. I'm trying to see if I can get a line on it from here, which I can't. And I'm trying to... Wait, is that the helicopter? No. The arty is not visible to me. So, whatever. I'm like, yep, all right, I'll get out of here. I'm going to go support Jomo in the OF-40.
All right.
Maybe I can get a line on him.
Warheads and codes
can I?
Are in our possession.
No.
Head to the comp
no,
tower.
Cass. You can't get a line on that tank. Go. Just go.
You're going to
support
need to
the OF-40.
The
it's going
to
be important
to
about
working.
30 seconds. So I'm following up. I'm going to support this OF-40. And this is where I get a little too aggressive. All right. So we hit this area, and this area sucks, all right? So I'm going to hide here. I take the shot. I get the kill. For anyone who says I'm kill-stealing, really what this is I have a stupid fast reload. And because of that reload, I can take enemies out of the fight pretty damn quick. Because I can do that, I'm going to. Even if the guy has 1 HP left, he's still putting out damage. And it's a lot better for me to take him. So I see the arty. I decide to not go for the arty. Someone else gets the arty first. There's an M60 here. I line up my shot, and now I'm backing up. I'm letting that OF-40 take the shot. I switch my target, and I destroy the BMV-2. The M60 now has my attention, but the OF-40 gets it first. So I'm going to drive up here. I call out target left. Someone drops smoke somewhere. Jace also lets me know, yes, we got a BMD-1. He gets a shot on me, but I blow him to bits. So now I'm coming back forward. I put a round into that AM max. Jace gets the kill. I'm coming forward again. I know that there's a bagel panzer over there. Or not a bagel, an upgraded M41. The M41 gets a shot on me. I'm like, oh, that's bad. All right, so I'm going to back up some more, try and break contact, let that OF-40 take the hit. OF-40 backs up. I fire again to get the kill. OF-40 gets the kill on the other M41. We now have a Type 59 up here. Are you noticing something, by the way? Notice who's engaged right now. It is the swing fire, the OF-40, one of them, and the LAV-300. And look at what we're doing. So I decide the BMP-1's a bigger target. I back up to avoid fire. I fire again. Now, notice that I'm mobile. I am more mobile than just about everyone else out here right now. We all miss. We just couldn't hit anything to save our lives that time. I should have fired at that Type 59. I don't know why I didn't, but I didn't. That doesn't matter.
Generators up. Encrypting and sending
I take out the T-62. And I go hunting a bit. And I notice this BMD-2 here, and I'm like, well, crap. At this point, Jace calls out again, T-92 rear, so I switch my target. I gotta take him out quick because he's putting rounds into our M60, and I get him.
We're good. The transport is waiting for us on a beach at the west side
okay.
of the island.
Okay, so now I'm going south. Someone's going to go deal with those helicopters up there, I hope. I hope. And I'm like, all right, well, I'm going to sit up. Yeah, you know what? They're probably going to need some help down there. That's fine. Let's go give them some help down below. So I'm like, all right, let's meander our way over here. You know, this looks like a decent place to set up at, maybe. I'm like, wait a second. There are contacts down there. Why am I not down there? Because Tejomo is the only one down there, and I don't trust that M60 to be actually able to do anything. So I'm like, you know what? I have a height advantage here. I'm like, yeah, I think I just made a mistake. Whatever. I get the bagel panzer. I should have let Jace get him, but you know what?
There's the transport. Hold the area and fight the whole attackers until the missile.
Yeah, I missed that shot. Oh god, we got targets behind us. All right, so Jace calls it out. We have targets behind us. I got a PAC-90 and a Leopard 1 back here. I'm trying to get into cover now, and I get saved by sliding down a hill. So I'm like, okay, there's a Leopard 1. I have enemies on both sides of me shooting at me. All right, this is very, very bad. And you know what? I have this moment where I'm like, screw it. I'm like, he's giving me his back, he's giving me his boom. Right into the rear armor. I'm like, alright, you know what? Now that we've dealt with the enemies in our rear, I can do what I'm made for. I'm not hiding anymore. I still actually have pretty decent camouflage against these guys. Artie's firing, I don't care. This OF-40 and I have got to kill more enemies and take them out quickly. Now I realize I have a hostile in my rear. I spin around. I use my superior turret rotation to take him out. And now I'm like, oh god, there's a bagel panzer back there. I'm not bothering to try and rotate my hull because I'm a wheeled vehicle. I can't rotate my hull. Now, something tells me that there might be something else back here. I don't know what it was that clued me in on this, but there's something, and I run into the M60. I realize, hey, wait, there's a target. And I'm like, all right, well, I'll go help. I probably have a faster refire rate than anyone else, and I probably can get a line on this OF-40 or whatever the hell this thing is. The Scorpion, I think, before anyone else can. So I'm coming around slowly, I get a line, and I kill him. And that's the kill on the OF-40. Notice, okay, Jace died sometime during that engagement. Tejomo, who was the guy who was actually holding everything together with me, mostly, he came in, he's already dead. He was down here and just got swarmed.
You've done well,
but I did a pretty good job at defending and holding that rear area long enough, basically, for the rest of our team to show up. Now, I didn't get a screenshot of the damage stats on this one. I'm sorry. But you saw there that I wasn't necessarily sniping. I was moving up, and I was actually supporting one of our MBTs in his engagement. That is a good thing to do. You want to support your MBT. You also, in PvE, mind you, want your MBT to hold enemy fire. Okay? In PvP, I don't think this works very well. Again, I'm not a PvP player, but what I imagine happening is if you saw me do this a couple times against the AI. Okay, that MBT may be closer, but that tank destroyer behind him can dish out a lot more damage than he can, so I might one-shot him, so I'm going to shoot him first. And I'm pretty certain that would be what would happen in PvP. In PvE, however, you could afford to be a bit more risky. Get more forward. Support your MBTs. Put some damage down. Use your better mobility to your advantage, all right? Let's look at something here. So I'm a tier 4, all right? Let's compare this thing to the swing fire. My swing fire is not fully upgraded, however. That's not what I wanted, garage. Let's look at the swing fire's upgrades. Does he get any mobility? He gets a better engine. All right, so he gets down to 2.9 seconds to 32 kilometers per hour. 2.9, all right? That's a bit faster than I am. But on his acceleration, look at my top speed. Now, I'm not going to get there quickly, but look at that. All right? I'm sitting at 104 kilometers per hour max speed. He's sitting at 52.2. Now, he has a tracked vehicle, but you get the point. I actually have decent mobility compared to a swing fire. Now, the swing fire is not the most mobile light vehicle in the world. Let's look at my XM800T. All right, he has better mobility than I do. I have a bit better top speed, but it's not that extreme. And honestly, our camouflage ratings aren't that different. I'm at 0.308, he's at 0.385. And our view range isn't that different either. And that's a tier 3 scout vehicle, all right? So you can move up and you can scout if you need to. I wouldn't recommend it. You have not as great a view range as the swing fire and not as good camouflage. But you can still get up there and you can still do it if you have to. The one thing you can't do is you cannot take a hit. Let me repeat that. You cannot take a hit. Say it again. You can't take a hit in a LAV 300. You don't have a lot of hit points. You don't have any armor. Actually, I'm pretty certain high explosive rounds will probably pen you. Do not get hit. You saw me get hit. Back up, get a wall, rock, something in between me and my enemy, and then play poke and shoot. Poking out, taking a shot, pulling back. I have very fast reload. I can poke out, take a shot, pull back. Poke out, take a shot, pull back. I can do that every 4.2 seconds. And learn your enemy's weak points. In that mission, I was facing at tier. So I did not have to worry much about hitting weak points. I was just laying rounds into them. All right. So let's take this out for a live session PvE. Now that you've seen what I can do in PvE with this, let's see what I will do today in PvE with this, which is different because, as you know, or, well, probably not, but trying to play and comment for you guys is not the easiest thing in the world. So we're going to jump into a mission here, and we're going to see. It's probably going to be tier 4 and 5, I'm thinking. Maybe 3 and 4. I try and guess based on this, the tier chart, what I'm going to be getting into here, but we'll see. There aren't a lot of players on this set. It's a Sunday morning. There aren't a lot of players on. All right, so I am high tier along with a starship. I hope the starship knows how to do this. I hope. Because otherwise, this is going to be a painful mission. We don't have any scouting. We have four main battle tanks and a tank destroyer. So remember how I said that I can scout if I have to? Right. Okay, this mission. This is one of my least good missions, actually. Oh, great. All right. Let's get this rolling, shall we? Now, I'm going to go straight out and probably try and cross the river here. Excuse me. Because I can probably get a decent vantage point up there. But I'm not going to be afraid to take any targets of opportunity that wander across my path in the meantime. Now, hopefully, my friends here will understand what they're doing. Or understand what I'm doing, at least.
Enemy has support disabled. Black Company, I hope you're ready for the cold. Time to move in on the cartel.
Alright, so we're going to come down here. Wheeled vehicle, remember. All right, so I've successfully gotten my ass across the river. Now let's see if I can get into a good firing position. All right, so we have a light tank down there. This is not a good firing position.
Identify target. Hostile.
We have bunches of enemies here. All right. They've spotted me already. Yep, remember how I said don't get hit?
Incoming arty.
So now that I've gotten their entire team's attention, remember I also said mobility's your friend here?
Target destroyed.
It is very easy to reposition this vehicle.
We've received reports of black market drugs stored here. Classic cartel move. Go do what tanks do best.
Alright, I don't have a good line on him. Am I gonna get a good line on him? I can't tell. At the same time, I don't want to get target focused here. Alright, good. Someone took him out. But I'm gonna start pushing up. Because I need to support. That is my duty, is to support my allies here. Simultaneously, I don't want to be an idiot. So I'm gonna come over here. I'm going to see this AMX.
Sailed him.
I'm going to put a round into him. All right, I can't see him anymore. But I'm going to sneak ahead here. Damn it, they just keep moving on me.
Identify.
All right,
tank.
We got some targets up here. Including their artillery. So I'm going to turn that on.
Penetrated.
And I'm silenced now. Okay. They got taken out. That's good. Okay, we got a TD across the river. He's dead. This is the problem with playing in the same game with a starship. They tend to have an amazing ability to kill things before you can. Now I'm taking a risk here, because I'm out in the open again. We're not spotted.
Identify target. Hostile, tank.
Holy Toledo.
Penetrated.
So we're going to back up. Reload.
Target eliminated.
Kill him.
Identify target. Hostile, tank.
Reload, kill him before he can shoot at me. Lose target on him. I have my target again.
Target down.
And I take him out. Now I know roughly where there already was.
Identify.
Okay, so we have more targets we just located. Now, this BMD-2 is my primary concern. Well, not really. He just got shot up. And I'm just keeping an eye on
penetrated.
What else is going on around me.
No pet.
There's that BMD-2 again. Alright, he's dead. Good.
Target eliminated.
I knocked him out now.
Identify target.
I'm sliding forward again.
Hostile.
I can see they're already.
They're
already is now dead. I'm backing up again. Missed him. Need to aim more towards the front. All right, we have another target over there. I can push up a little bit more now. I'm spotted by someone. I took out that M41's gun, but I'm still in a bad position.
Target hit.
Very bad position. This is not where I want to be. I'm
going to
reload first and kill him. That Bagel Panzer is not in my vision range, and that's fine. I can't really see him, so I'm going to pop up onto the road now. And we have contacts rear. So this just became my responsibility because I'm back here. Remember how I had better gun depression off my ass?
Hostile, tank.
All right, so now we have a big issue.
Enemy destroyed.
Remember how I said I should withdraw from this Bagel Panzer, but I don't. All right. I'm going to swing back around. Do I have a line on these guys yet? No. Those guys are in a ditch or depression or something. Now, this leaves me in an awkward position because I know that they're back there and I don't want to leave my guys hanging. I really just don't want to leave my boys out there hanging. So I'm going to come up and I'm going to flank this guy. All right, we lost one of our guys now. Unfortunately, they were fighting in a position where I could not get a shot on them. All right, so we have multiple enemies back here. Take him out first. Engine. And that took him out. Good. Now I'm going to cross the river again. Because they haven't taken out.
No effect.
Oh, shoot.
Direct hit.
That got his fuel tank. What the hell is he thinking about? He's just sitting there.
Target down.
All right. So I'm going to run over here and I'm going to take out these black market shipments because we need to do that. Someone does need to do it. And the Starship's going to take that one and so I'll come over here. So that Leopard 1 is sitting up there sniping. He didn't do a bad job, actually. He got 7 kills and the Starship got 7. Honestly, hey, way to go. I mean, I'm a tank destroyer. I have a lot of DPS, so I can afford to do... Excuse me. Sorry, I know I rammed into you, but I'm also a wheeled vehicle, which means that my ability to maneuver is bad. Where is it? It's around here somewhere. Maybe behind the building. Oh, where the hell did they put it this time? It should be glowing white or something. I don't know. Ah, there it is.
Coder, save him.
Well done, Black Company. Got some of that poison off the streets.
Okay, so I don't know where the other enemy tanks are. I honestly have no idea. We don't have a scout tank, and we don't have any artillery to light it up for us, so I just have no clue. I'm going to go for the cap, I think. I don't think I'm going to. We have 2 minutes left. I think I'm going for the cap. I'm asking my team to go for the cap. I'm going to put myself in the cap. Because it's going to be a fairly long cap time. Hopefully less than 2 minutes.
Hold that bridge. Don't let enemy reinforcements...
Yes, less than 2 minutes. All right, good. There we go. So 12 kills. Not the best I've ever done, but not bad. And actually, everyone kind of pulled their well. Okay, we won't talk about that Leopard 1 and the M60. But everyone kind of pulled their weight in this match. Well, you just won't talk about that Leopard 1 and 60. So when played correctly, the LAV-300 can be an incredibly powerful asset. You can also get yourself killed very, very easily. If you notice, I'm at over half health, and I haven't used my repair consumable. Okay? I just haven't used it. I'm sitting here. I haven't used it yet. I still have some heat rounds left, and I still have a fair amount of Sabo left. That's my kit out for Sabo for gear. I just have fairly even mixed heat, and ho, we found one. I don't know what that Leopard just fired, but he fired something out there. All right, well, before we can kill them, yeah. I don't know where they were sitting, but they were sitting somewhere. Honestly, I didn't care as long as the match ended, because I think I've probably gone over with this episode. Let the game figure out what it's doing. And that's good. There's a 3x reward multiplier online on right now, from now until I think the 30th. So I've been taking advantage of it, a lot of advantage of it. Been trying to get as many daily rewards as I can for my vehicles. So this will finish loading. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. This month is nice. There we go. All right. So shooter and blue star. Nice. Would have been cool if I could get a destroyer as well, but the fact that I capped my team looks good to me. You can see premium, I got 6,000. Again, there's a... look here. Yep. So I outscored that starship by just a little bit. All right. Not by much, but I outscored him. I dealt more damage. I got more spots. How did he get that close to me then? I destroyed a component. I got more spots, did more damage. Ah, I didn't have as many kill assists. That's what it is. Okay. So, that's that. In terms of consumables, I have standard package. Let's take a look over here. I don't have a med kit on this thing, honestly. I have a repair kit and spare parts, because that way I can trigger this without blowing that. And I have the mid-tier maintenance kit. Retrofits, I'm mounting intercom systems right now. That boosts up my crew stats by 5%. And I'm mounting a thermal sleeve to increase my rate of fire. I could probably also give myself not that, maybe the magnetic actuator to increase my damage and decrease my aim time, but honestly I'm pretty happy with it where it is. It does fine for PvE. So that has been the LAV. Oh, commander, I have Sabrina Washington, because vision, aim speed, camo factor, penalty camo factor, and base capture. I'm just going for Sabrina Washington then. So, there you have it. This has been the LAV-300. If you enjoyed this video, please give me a like, comment, subscription. I'm going to try and give you guys as much background and history knowledge as I can in each of these videos. The problem is that some of these videos either don't exist, weren't deployed, or there's just very little info on them because there weren't many of them deployed, like the LAV-300. So thank you so much for watching. This has been Mr. Kasarian. Hope you enjoyed the episode. See you next time, and good hunting.